हेलो एवरीवन, ओड टू द वेस्ट विंड बाय पी बी शैली। वी आर गोइंग टू एनालाइज द फिफ्थ कैंटो ऑफ दिस ओड। हियर इन दिस ओड शैली मेक्स अ पैशनेट अपील और प्ली टू द वेस्ट विंड एंड एक्सप्रेसेस हिज डिजायर टू बी वन विद द वेस्ट विंड। ही राइट्स, Make me thy lyre, even as the forest is. He wishes that the west wind, or he appeals to the west wind to make him its lyre. Lyre is a musical instrument or an acolyte. He wishes that the west wind should make Shelley his lyre or an acolyte, even as the forest is. Even as the forest is means like the west wind has made the forest its musical instrument, or we can listen to the sound of the west wind in the forest when it blows. What if my leaves are falling like its own? He says that it does not matter whether my leaves are also falling like the leaves of the forest. The tumult of thy mighty harmonies will take from both a deep autumnal tone. He says that the tumult, the commotion of thy mighty harmonies, thy west winds, mighty, strong harmonies, melodies. The melodious song of the west wind, when it flows through the forest, will take from both a deep autumnal tone. Will take from both means the forest and the wind, a deep tone of autumn. Sweet though in sadness, he says that this tone or this sound of autumn is though sad, but it is sweet, as we have already seen that the season of autumn is associated with the falling of leaves and falling of temperature. So it is not at all a comfortable season, but Shelley calls it sweet because only after death life can come. New leaves on the trees and plants, new flowers will come only when the old leaves and old plants die. Be thou spirit fierce, be you, again he is addressing the west wind. Be you spirit fierce, powerful, fearful spirit, my spirit. He wishes that the spirit of autumn should become his own spirit. Be thou me, be you me. He urges the west wind to become his own self. Impetuous one, impetuous, vigorous, arduous wind. He urges the wind to be him. He wants to become one with the west wind. Drive my dead thoughts over the universe. He tells the west wind to drive his dead thoughts over the universe. He wishes to do away with his old thoughts, like withered leaves, to quicken a new birth. Like the west wind carries away the withered, dead, dried leaves in order to quicken the birth of new leaves and flowers. Shelley says that like the leaves of the autumn forest, his thoughts are also dead and he wishes them to be vitalized by the west wind. And by the incantation of this verse, incantation, chanting, and by the chanting of this verse, that is his appeal which he has made to the west wind through this poem. Scatter, scatter is spread far away, as from an unextinguished hearth. Like from an unextinguished hearth. Hearth is a furnace which is not extinguished. Ashes and sparks. Ashes and sparks come out from a hearth or a furnace which is not fully extinguished or blown out. My words among mankind. He tells the west wind to scatter his prophetic words amongst mankind to all the human beings like from a fiery furnace. He says that the furnace of his heart is also not fully extinguished, and sparks and ashes come out, can still come out. That is, new ideas can still come out from his own heart and mind, and he wishes the west wind to spread it far and wide. Be through my lips to unawakened earth the trumpet of a prophecy. He tells the west wind to act as a trumpet of a prophecy of coming good days through his lips, and spread this message, take this message to the unawakened earth, to the people who are sleeping, that is, who are not fully aware of life. He wishes that the west wind should become a trumpet, a musical instrument, and announce to the sleepy and this indifferent world that certainly a glorious future, a good future, will come after the present era of gloom and sadness. In the last two lines, he gives what is the prophecy. O wind, if winter comes, can spring be far behind? If winter comes, then spring cannot stay far behind. Spring will come just after the winter season. The winter season stands for suffering and affliction, and the spring season stands for happiness, joy, and prosperity. So, when the winter comes, when suffering comes to humanity, happiness and joy also follows it. Thus, we see that in the beginning of this canto, the poet wishes that the west wind should bring out the prophetic notes hidden in his own mind by playing on the poet's mind as if he were the lyre or acolyte of the west wind. And he says that in a manner in which the west wind brings out the latent or the hidden music from the trees in the forest, it should also bring out the hidden ideas in the mind of the poet. He says that like the forest, he is presently seeing the autumn of his era, and he wishes the west wind to become one with him and help him to scatter his thoughts over the world in order to become the harbinger of a new period of prosperity and development. He says that he is in a miserable condition and the world is also in a miserable condition, and he must give place to a happier and brighter new order. He expresses his idealism in the last line, and he believes in the perfectibility of human nature. Thus we see that in this stanza, beginning with making him as his lyre or acolyte, he urges the west wind to be one with him. Be thou spirit fierce, my spirit, be thou me, impetuous one. And he wants the wind to help him to drive away the dead thoughts from over the world in order to bring a new humanitarian universal order. Comparing his thoughts with the dead leaves which the west wind blows, and also the leaves in order to quicken a new birth. He thus wishes, prays the west wind to spread this message of his, that spring will come after the winter is over. There is no doubt about it. He wishes that the people of England should be optimistic, because according to him, winter indicates the dark times in England of his times, and spring indicates a very bright future for the people. Thus we see that in the first three cantos of the poem, Shelley writes about nature, but in the last two cantos, the fourth and the fifth one, he writes about his own expectations from the west wind and what he wishes the west wind, what changes the west wind should bring about in his life, how the west wind should help him to become a more free person, to lift him from the difficulties, the sorrows, the pains of life. And in the fifth canto, he wishes the west wind to spread his message of health and happiness and better times. Thank you.